Hello everyone, I Professor Bhavik Kumar M. Kataria welcomes you into the video series of Information and Network Security. We are discussing unit number 7. In that case, we will discuss few topics like digital signature. In terms of digital signature, we will discuss properties of digital signature, requirements of digital signature, and security in digital signature. Then after, we will discuss various digital signature schemes, and we will discuss NIST digital signature algorithm. Get it? So there are various kinds of algorithm. Mostly NIST is an organization which is suggesting few algorithms. So we will discuss in detail with the algorithms as well as example. But before today, we have discussed unit number 5 and unit number 6. So in case of unit number 5, we have discussed various topics like cryptographic hash function, application of cryptographic hash function, simple hash function, requirements of simple hash function, hash function based on cipher block chaining, and secure hash algorithm. Then after, we have discussed message authentication code, its requirements, its security, hash functions used in MSE, and block cipher used in MSE. So whatever the topics of unit number 6 and unit number 5 we have discussed till today, so let make some highlight on this. So first, we have started with the hash function. So whatever the issues we were facing during the symbol table presentation, so to overcome this type of problems occurs into the symbol table problem, we have used the hash function. Get it? And we have performed various operations on hash function like insert, delete, search, and update like a symbol table. Next, we have discussed how to implement hash function using a hash table. So if you will look, so whenever there is a table, it is look like a, suppose you can consider same like a normal table. So whenever we are inserting a value inside the hash table, so we are using the hash function, and from the output of hash function, whatever the position we are getting, on that particular position we are inserting our key value. So that is the actual fundamental behind the hash function and hash table. Then after, we have discussed collision, which is a problem occurs into the hash function and hash table. Whenever we are getting the same position for more than one key values, get it? So we cannot store more than one value at a single position. So this problem is known as a collision, and we have discussed a few collision resolution techniques like open addressing and separate chaining. Various hash functions we have discussed, like first we have discussed division method, then after we have discussed multiplication method, then after we have discussed mid square method, and then after we have discussed folding method. In terms of collision resolution technique, we have discussed open addressing and chaining. In terms of open addressing, we have discussed linear probing, quadratic probing, and double hashing. Then after, our next session was about the cryptographic hash function, that is our second session. So we have started with the need of cryptographic hash function. So cryptographic hash function is generally used to reduce the size of message. Whenever there is a very long size of message and we are applying the hash function on it, so we are getting a fixed length of particular message. It means, suppose there is an n bit message, so in place of n bit message we are getting fixed size of l bit message, and this output is known as a message digest and hash digest. So that is the fundamentals of cryptographic hash function. In that case, we have used many cases, like first case that was for the message authentication, and we have discussed the properties of cryptographic hash functions, We have discussed crypt analysis in case of cryptographic hash function. Then after we have discussed secure hash algorithm in place of earlier technique like MD4 and MD5. So we are using secure hash algorithm. It means we are replacing the MD4 and MD5, and in place of MD4 and MD5 we are using SHA. Get it? So what is the difference between MD4, MD5 and SHA? So in case, suppose we are comparing it with the MD5. So MD5 is producing 128-bit output, whereas SHA is producing 160-bit output. Get it? So these are the calculation of how we are considering 160-bit in case of SHA. Then after our third session was about the message authentication code. In that case, we have discussed the need of message authentication code. Generally, it is used to reduce the content modifications, sequence modification, timing modifications, source repudiation, destination repudiation, and MASCAD. It means malicious user or third party integrity. Get it? So to reducing this type of activity in between the channel, we are using message authentication code, and generally it is used for the authentication. First case, we have discussed three cases. One is for the authentication, second one authentication tied to the plain text, and third one is for the authentication tied to the ciphertext. And then after we have discussed message authentication code with encryption. Get it? So for the encryption key, we have used block cipher or stream cipher, and we have discussed four different cases with the encryption also. And first case was for the symmetric key encryption, and remaining three cases with the public key encryption. So in case of symmetric key encryption, we got the confidentiality and authentication, whereas in case of public key encryption, there was three cases were there. On second case, we got the confidentiality. On third case, we got the authentication and signature. And for the fourth case, we got the confidentiality, authentication and signature, all this thing. So that was everything about the message authentication code. Then after, we have applied the hash function on message authentication code. So these are the fundamentals about the earlier session. Today we are going to discuss digital signature. Get it? So let's start today's session. What is about the digital signature? So first, in case of digital signature, we will start with the need of the digital signature. So let's see what is the need of digital signature. So here we have two parties, sender party and receiver party. Here Bhavik is a sender and Dhruvi is a receiver. Suppose Bhavik is sending a message to Dhruvi, get it? And Dhruvi is receiving a message from Bhavik. So in that case, why we require the digital signature? So thing is that first understand the what type of problems can be occurred, get it? Suppose Bhavik is sending a message to Dhruvi, like suppose Dhruvi's birthday is arriving, and Bhavik is sending a message to Dhruvi like I will gift a bracelet to you on your birthday. Get it? So that is a commitment from the Bhavik side. Get it? So Bhavik is going to gift a bracelet to Dhruvi on her birthday. Get it? So now what are the problems? Let's see. Suppose Dhruvi is receiving a message, which type of problems can be occurred? First, actually I want to explain you authentication, non-repudiation, message integrity and confidentiality. Get it? So first we will check the authentication. What is authentication? Look, like Dhruvi have to know about this message is actually sent by the Bhavik or not. Get it? So that's why there is a need of verification, because this message is sent by the actual sender or not. This thing is known as authentication. So Dhruvi will check. So whatever the message of commitment to gift a bracelet, so that is that message is from the Bhavik or like any other family members like brothers, sisters, parents, get it? So Dhruvi have to check who one is sending this message, get it? So this thing is known as authentication. Suppose Dhruvi is able to know this message is actually sent by the Bhavik, so Dhruvi is able to identify the sender. This thing is authentication. Now non-repudiation. Suppose Dhruvi's birthday is arrived and Dhruvi will ask to Bhavik, you did one commitment to me, like you are going to gift me a bracelet on my birthday, so today is my birthday, so where is my gift? So Bhavik will say, I did not done any type of commitment like this. So Dhruvi will show up the message, whatever Dhruvi received. So Dhruvi will show up the message to Bhavik, yeah, that message is sent by the you. So Bhavik will say, no, I did not send any type of message to you like this. So this thing is as a non-repudiation, get it? So Bhavik is running away from their commitment, get it? Actually Bhavik sent that particular message, but right now Bhavik is running far away from his commitment, get it? Because Bhavik don't want to purchase a bracelet for Dhruvi, get it? So this thing is known as a non-repudiation, because Dhruvi has no proof regarding like surety about that message was sent by the Bhavik or anyone else, get it? So in that case Bhavik can run away from his commitment. So to reduce this type of problem, we are using digital signature, because whenever digital signature is there, so Dhruvi will show up the digital signature to Bhavik, that message is actually sent by you, here there is your signature, get it? So you cannot run far away from your commitment. You have to purchase a bracelet for me, you have to gift a bracelet to me, get it? So doing the use of digital signature, we can overcome this type of problem. Another thing, message integrity, like someone third party is going to hack, like there is one brother-in-law of Bhavik or sister-in-law of Bhavik, and suppose they want to do any mimicry with them, or so they can integrate the message, they can intercept the message, and in place of bracelet they are writing gold bracelet, get it? So by receiving this type of message, Dhruvi will happily got the message, yeah, there is a gold bracelet. But actually a gold bracelet message is not sent by the Bhavik, get it? So Bhavik was sent a message only for gifting the bracelet, but someone, whatever he or she should be, brother-in-law or sister-in-law, will modify the message and interpret bracelet into gold bracelet, get it? So this thing is known as a message integrity, like third party can intercept the message and change the meaning of message, get it? So whenever birthday will arrive, so Bhavik will purchase a normal bracelet for Dhruvi, but Dhruvi will ask to him, like, you did the commitment for gold bracelet, not this, get it? So again there is an issue or a dispute, get it? So to solve out this type of disputes and issues, we are using the digital signature. Mostly currently digital signatures are used in the banking side most of the cases, get it? To avoid many types of frauds, get it? And right now, if we will discuss about the functions of digital signature, so there is authentication, non-repudiation, and message integrity. So if we will look into limitation also, so there is a limitation, confidentiality, and message integrity. Confidentiality we have already discussed during our earlier session. So that is the confidentiality of message, like another one cannot read the message. Here someone read, someone able to read the message, like brother-in-law or sister-in-law able to read the message, like Bhavik is going to gift the bracelet to Dhruvi, So then and then they try to intercept the message and change the message bracelet into the gold bracelet. Why? Because they are able to read the message. Confidentiality says no one able to read the message in between the channel. Get it? So confidentiality is not available in case of digital signature. Whereas authentication and non-repudiation and message integrity available. Here one limitation, message integrity also. So you have a doubts, sir, you have written the message integrity in function as well as limitation. So let's see, whenever we are using the normal case of digital signature, so we are not getting message integrity. Get it? So at that time, message integrity is a limitation of digital signature. But whenever we are using the advanced features of digital signature, get it? This thing is known as a digital signature standard, DSS. So in case of digital signature standard, we are getting the functionality of message integrity. So actually message integrity was not available in case of digital signature, only authentication and non-repudiation was available. So we were able to achieve authentication and non-repudiation by using the digital signature. Suppose with the authentication and non-repudiation, we actually want to achieve message integrity also. So at that time we have to use digital signature standard. Get it? So that is the basic fundamental of digital signature. Now let's see how it is going to be implemented. So let's see the structure about the digital signature. Get it? Now that is the basic structure of digital signature. Actually it is known as a generic model of digital signature, but simply I am calling it as a structure. Get it? Whenever you are going to appear into the examination, so a question should be asked to you, draw the generic model of digital signature and explain. So you have to draw this figure with the accuracy and all number of components, and you have to explain the whole fundamentals. Get it? Now see how a structure is look like. So it is our actual message, like that is let me cover it. That is our actual message. Get it? So that message Bhavik want to forward towards the Dhruvi. Get it? Here Bhavik is a sender party and Dhruvi is a receiver party. Get it? So what Bhavik will do, Bhavik will use the digital signature generation algorithm. So now question in mind, what are the digital signature generation algorithm? So in our next session we will discuss various types of algorithm suggested by NIST. Get it? So that is the institute or organization which is suggesting the different algorithms in market to the people. Get it? Who are currently using the information and security or computer networks or any other type of fundamentals. Let's see, message is here in place of whenever we are sending a normal message, in place of sending a normal message, we are implementing the digital signature algorithm on that particular message. Get it? And we are generating a signature here. That is S stand for the signature. Get it? So by using the digital signature generation algorithm, we are generating the signature. Keep in your mind how we are going to generate the digital signature. Get it? So to generate the digital signature, a sender party is using the digital signature generation algorithm. As well as whenever receiver party will receive the message, so receiver party will use the digital signature verification algorithm. Get it? Here generation algorithm is going to be used, whereas at a destination side, a verification algorithm is going to be used. Get it? Now, let's see, Bhavik will use the private key. Get it? During the digital signature generation. Whereas in case of verification, Dhruvi will use public key. Get it? That is the public key by the Bhavik. Here that is a private key used by the Bhavik. So that is the vice versa. Whenever same thing look like encryption and decryption, whatever it should be like digital signature generation. Suppose sender party is using the private key, so that key sender will make the public for receiver, and receiver will use the same key as a public key. Get it? So whatever the private key of Bhavik is here, that will become the public key for the Dhruvi. Get it? So whenever message is going to be sent into the channel, so message will sent with the actual message plus signature. That is our actual message. Get it? Here we are receiving, that is our actual message. Actual message M, and it is a signature. This one is a signature. So whenever this message and signature received by the receiver party, I mean at a Dhruvi's place, so Dhruvi will use the verification algorithm to verify here whatever the generation algorithm was used. So after verifying, Dhruvi will compare with the, this written signature. Get it? So if Dhruvi will able to verify the same, then signature is valid, otherwise not. Get it? So it means message was authenticated or sent by the Bhavik only if signature is valid, and if signature is not valid, so it means someone hacked the message, or someone insert the integrity, or any other person can send the message. So these are the doubts in receiver's part if signature is not valid. If signature is valid, so there is no need to think anything. There is authentication and non-repudiation. It means that was, if signature is valid, so that was sent by the Bhavik. That is authentication and non-repudiation. It means due to the signature, whenever look like we have discussed the bracelet gift, so on the day of birthday, Dhruvi can present the signature of Bhavik to him and show up him like that is your signature, and you did the commitment for the gifting a bracelet. So that is a non-repudiation. So sender party cannot run away from their commitment. And in case of next thing, we will use encryption. So we will use encryption to receive the for the message integrity and confidentiality. Get it? Because in our earlier cases, we receive only authentication and non-repudiation, but parallelly we want to achieve message integrity and confidentiality. So there is a need to use encryption as well as one cryptographic hash function. So two things here used, one is cryptographic hash function and one is encryption. Encryption is for the confidentiality and cryptographic hash function for the message integrity. This message integrity is achieved by the cryptographic hash function, whereas confidentiality is received by the encryption. Get it? So let's see what sender party is doing. Whatever the actual message is there, so sender party is using cryptographic hash function, and after using the cryptographic hash function, Bhavik is making the encryption on that particular message through the Bhavik's private key. Get it? And by after the encryption, Bhavik will generate the digital signature, and by this digital signature we were able to achieve the authentication and non-repudiation. So here we are able to achieve four things: authentication, non-repudiation, message integrity and confidentiality. Get it? So how this thing is happen? Whenever receiver party, I mean Dhruvi, will receive the message, so Dhruvi will use the cryptographic hash function, whatever they used by the sender's party, used by the Bhavik, and again Dhruvi have a digital signature, so Dhruvi will decrypt the message, so Dhruvi will get the hash function hash dash, so Dhruvi will compare the h with the h dash. Suppose there is same hash function, so it means signature is valid. Suppose there is a different hash function, so it means signature is not valid. So suppose there is a signature is valid, so Dhruvi will get the message integrity, confidentiality, authentication and non-repudiation, everything. Get it? So hope you are able to understand the second case. In our previous case, we were not used the encryption and cryptographic hash function. Right now we are adding two things, cryptographic hash function on encryption on message, and by using these two things we are receiving message integrity and confidentiality. Get it? So here is one poem from the Harivansh Rai Bachchan for boosting your confidence. वृक्ष हो भले खड़े हो घने हो बड़े एक पत छाँव की मांग मत मांग मत मांग मत अग्निपथ 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 तू न थकेगा कभी तू न थमेगा कभी तू न मुड़ेगा कभी कर शपथ कर शपथ कर शपथ अग्निपथ 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 ये महान दृश्य है चल रहा मनुष्य है अश्रुस्वेद रक्त से लथपथ 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 अग्निपथ अग्निपथ अग्निपथ. सो ऑल द बेस्ट एंड गुड लक टू यू फॉर योर करंट सेमेस्टर स्टडी ड्यूरिंग दिस कोविड 19 सिचुएशंस. सो डू नॉट डीमोटिवेट एनी पॉइंट. इफ यू हैव एनी क्वेरी एनी प्रॉब्लम सो कॉन्टेक्ट टू मी एनी टाइम. I will help you every time. You can make your queries or any type of doubts into the comment box also. I will help. I will try my best to help you at every point. Let's see two approaches of digital signature. So whatever the two approaches are, one is for the DSS approach, digital signature standard, and one is for the RSA approach. RSA, R, S and A, these are the three characters of first name of the scientist. Whatever the three scientists have suggested this approach, by their first character of their name, we have chosen R, S and A. So in case of RSA approach, we are using the encryption, whereas in case of DSS approach, we are using digital signature only. It means cryptographic hash function. So here we are getting the message integrity in case of digital signature standard, and in case of RSA we are using confidentiality. Get it? Integrity and confidentiality. So in DSS approach we are getting the message integrity, and here we are getting in case of by doing the encryption decryptions we are getting the confidentiality about the message. Done. By using this approach we are getting confidentiality. And by using this approach we are receiving message integrity. It. So no need to discuss more here. We have already discussed both this case. Here on message we are using cryptographic hash function, and then after we are making the encryption. So by doing this thing, same thing, it is going to be occur at receiver side, and receiver will compare both this thing, and suppose receiver is getting the same values, so it is the actual confidentiality from the sender side. Same thing in case of here digital signature. After the using the cryptographic hash function, there is a signature is going to be used, and by using the signature, same thing reverse side procedure is going to be occur at receiver's place, and there is a achievement of message integrity. Get it? So this was basic fundamentals about the digital signature. If you have any doubts, you can ask to me. In next session, we will discuss NIST algorithm, and it will cover session number 5. So stay connected, stay healthy. Thank you very much.